Welcome everyone. I am Shishir Gupta. I am the founder and CEO of Startup Brain. So without wasting time, we can start with your questions. We have Anjali from our HR department. She would be helping us in moderating this session. So Anjali, you can find out those who are raising the hands. You can ask them to start.
Yes, sure, sir. Anuj Abhishek has been raising her hands. You can ask, sir.
Yeah, Anuj, your question first. Anuj, you have to unmute and speak.
Sir,
hello. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening. Please tell me.
Actually, sir, I am 18 years old, biotech student, and I want to do biotech startup. But I unable to connect with right people. So how can I connect with them, sir? And how can I start my biotech startup, sir?
Do you have the idea as of now?
Yeah, I am working on that, sir. But I need some partners to work. I need co-founders, sir.
First of all, you. To take the inspiration, because if you find out any successful startup doing good, better to do the same model. Startup is more about disrupting. That means offer the homogeneous product, do the same thing but at a better price and more convenience to your customers. Once you are done with it, once you have the concept with you, then you have to go for MVP, the minimum viable product. And in that minimum viable product, just build the basic things. Don't build everything, right? So, if suppose you are building a cycle, so you need not build all the things, say the ring of that cycle may not be required. Just a basic product is okay, right? Test that product. Once the product is workable, then you can search out for people. So, I don't know, you said you are looking for people. What kind of people? Are you looking for mentors or the industry connect or the customers? So, but I tell you all three. Start searching for the CXOs, that means C-level officers of big corporate in the biotech companies. They might become your investor, mentor, as well as they can become your customer if you are making something that can sell to those companies. Okay? Alright, next question.
Ashok Kumar, you can ask the next question.
Yeah, good evening, sir. This is Ashok from GTNC Korea.
Okay.
Yeah, we are a crane manufacturing company in Korea, and my CEO is a lady. She's a Korean based woman, and she started her own products like cosmetics.
Okay.
And they are of premier range. The normal people cannot afford, only high top creamy layer people can afford. I think on Feb 1st I received a mail from you, so that from that day I am in follow up with your mail, but I didn't get any response, sorry to address in this forum. So now my question is, I would like to access the investors like B2B.
So the what first is the best way?
And one more thing, I have registered with this Startup India, Franchise India or Business X. We paid some amount, they said they'll give some leads. Almost all it is around 9 months now. I didn't get even one lead. I got stuck up here because I am resident in Korea. Actually, I have my backup in India. If I am there, I can bring at least one or two investors in my own known contacts. So I am unable to travel because of this COVID situation, and there is no exit also at present. So I need some input from you. So how to approach a real B2B? We have done everything. Our product is ready. We have launched our product in Korea. Now we are launching parallelly in Singapore and India. Our website is ready. Our product got CDSCO approval. All products have patent rights. And we have approached some dermatologists also.
Okay. So by B2B, you mean to say you are looking for investors or you are looking for the customers?
I am looking for customers, not investors. Investors, not customers.
So, You said you trade to Franchise India. Franchise India provides you investors also?
Yes.
Okay. All right. See, just recently on 10th of April, we had our demo day where we invited all 10 founders to participate, and 297 investors participated. Right. So yes, you can join our next demo day. In fact, you have to first follow the process. The process is, first and foremost, you have to build the pitch deck. That is the most important document. Once you have the pitch deck, you go to Startup Planes, and under the funding section, there is one page. You have to read that page. It will take you at least 10 minutes to read it entirely. Okay. We have mentioned the entire process, how things will work. After that, you need to apply. Once you apply, this goes, your application will go into our system, and automatically you will get a call. There will be a community manager assigned to you.
Okay.
And you will get a call. She will tell you when to send the pitch deck and where to send the pitch deck. Once the pitch deck is there, she will guide you how to make a better pitch deck, because that is the most important document. Once the pitch deck is ready, then you have to do a pitching to us. Once you pitch to us, three things will happen. Our team will analyze about your product, about your business, as well as how well you are pitching. And if all three things work fine, then we will tell you the next. In case your pitch deck is not good, then we will guide you. In case you are not fundable, then also we'll guide you. In case you are not getting opportunities, or you want to search out the investors yourself, then also we'll guide you.
Okay.
We are there completely for every founder, whatever they need, especially for funding. Our focus is 100% funding, and it does not matter whether you become our paid customer or not. We are here to support you.
Yes, sir. This process is a chargeable basis, or it's how to pay?
This is entirely free process. That is what I said. This is entirely free. Our objective, we built this organization on the basis of seva. Seva is something, serving the society.
Yes.
So there is a cost attached. When we suppose you need a pitch deck to be designed and built by the professionals, then we have lot of people in the team, they do it, so then there will be a charge, right? But if everything is fine, you don't need any of those services, then straightforward you can meet the investors through us, and there will be a fixed service fee on the success. Whatever amount of funding you raise, we'll be charging from that only.
Okay. And basically I am a mechanical engineer. My experience is completely different, technical. I came here as a overseas project manager. Now my company is diversifying the business. So this is completely new. I don't know how to fare, but I am searching for what the help I can get from others.
Entirely. We'll connect you. In fact, I'll connect you with one of my connections. She's the founder of Spendless Cosmetics. So that would be a very Singapore. That would be a very good connect for you. And as far as I know, she has more than 50,000 distributors all across the world. Right, single mother working very hard, and she has built a very big company. You will appreciate if you know about her. Definitely.
Okay, sir. Okay.
All right. Next question.
Thank you very much for your initiative, and we will also support you. In future course, we'll have a long journey with you. Thank you.
Definitely, 100%. Thank you so much, and we'll have these sessions every Tuesday. I would appreciate you come back on next also. Okay.
Oh yeah, please. I'll join. Thank you.
Sure.
Yeah, thanks for giving the opportunity.
Amit Jin, what's the question? Amit Jin.
Hi, Shishir.
Hi.
Okay, Shishir. We are into furniture business. And I have an experience of 20 years, so I've been serving the corporate houses. So we started our venture in November 2019, after doing complete survey of the industry. So we found out a vacuum in the furniture industry. We did a pilot project in June 2019. Once it was successful, we had entire payment and profits. We started our venture in November 2019. So till date, we have been doing all bootstrapping. We are three partners in all, and we have done decent amount of business. And it is a flight light model, no factory, nothing going. We have been aggregating the business, but we are doing it on regional basis. So we are right now operating in Delhi NCR, right? So we want to take it national now because we have a proven business model with established profits. And our vision has always been national, playing it national, right? So there are two, three things. First is that in case we continue to bootstrap, then we might not be able to go national in a very fast pace. Fine. So that is the reason we need funding. At the same time, will funding obstruct our style of business? Because there are people who tell us that the moment aapne fund managers ko ya, you know, people who are investing in your company, then it becomes more of a job again and less of your own business. Then you lose control over your business. So how true is that, first and foremost? And what kind of funding should a founder take care of? Ki yaar itna funding le taki control na jaye business ke upar.
Okay. So the first question first, when you say, you know, funding is required, yes. I'll tell you, sabse important is when you are scaling up,
yes.
You take any example. All, let's take the example of richest people in the world. Out of top 10, 7 came through the startup route. Whether it is Elon Musk, or you talk about Jeff Bezos, or anyone.
Right.
7 in the current scenario came through startup route. And I was researching, I researched 3 full years for my book, and I found none of these organizations, or to be very frank, none of the biggest and richest in the world have even survived without the external funding.
Okay.
There are companies, they delayed their funding, right? So, but that does not mean they have survived without the funding, because you need fund. Business is about money. So this is number one, it is clear. You need to have funds, but how to get the funds, that is more important question. Because while you approach the external investors, you need to have a particular model in place. A very good example is Bluewood, you know?
Sorry?
Bluewood, Noida-based company, they are part of, they were our members, right?
Okay.
Some Abhishek Singh or Abhinav Singh, I do not remember his name completely.
Okay.
So I interacted with him around 2.5 years ago. He's from Noida.
Okay.
And that time he was building that model, and he built a very good model.
Okay.
And he started selling through Amazon, he started selling, scaling up through distributors and all.
Mm.
And now it became a B2C kind of product. So, you know, suppose you require just one desk to work from home.
Mm.
That is a very good choice. You require one panel for the TV. It is a very good choice, right? So when you become a consumer brand, because again, another research says, most of the unicorns are towards the consumer side, not B2B.
Okay.
Right? If you dig deep into it, you will find that most of the unicorns are towards consumer, because it is very easy to disrupt the consumer directly. It's very difficult to go to the B2B side, right?
Okay.
Consumer's loyalty is far more than the B2B loyalty.
Okay.
Right? So that is how, if you focus on consumers directly, this will give you more margins. This will give you better customer loyalty references,
right.
And the delivery of the product will be direct to the consumer.
And now, easier also.
Now another question that you said, people say that, you know, investors will eat you up, or maybe, you know, command, yeah. You, like, this is entirely false.
Okay.
There is a legal document called term sheet.
Okay.
That defines everything, right? If you say I don't want your interference at all, then investor cannot interfere at all. It is as just like share market, right? Suppose you buy the share of TCS, 3150 is right now, right? So you buy 100 shares, 3 lakh something, and you can't do anything about TCS except once in a year when they invite you to do the voting.
Correct.
Similarly here, the same case, investor will not be able to do anything. But the best part is, the investors, these people are the people who are maybe celebrities or, you know, influential people in the industry. Suppose you get investment from a person, say, you know, who's from, say, a laminate or plywood company, like very big. So, or maybe from Pidilite Industries. So they understand the industry deep.
Correct.
They have the connections.
Correct.
They they can give you a kickstart by just referring and recommending, right? Suppose CEO or maybe CFO or CMO of such kind of organization comes to you, and they will not interfere, right? They will never interfere, because if you put a fine lining, if you put that particular lining, nobody can interfere. So that is called term sheet. That is why lawyers are required in place, and you know, we do all those documents. The funding comes, and I tell you, it's not difficult. People have created it a very difficult way. It's not the way it is depicted. If you have a model in place, if you approach those investors, if you approach, say, somebody who's a CEO of Pidilite or CXO, any CFO, CTO, if, example, they make a salary of, I'm just taking vague example, 1.2 crores per year, which is very normal, right? 10 lakh rupees a month, right? And if you ask that person, sir, give me 25 lakhs over a period of 3 years, right? And if you get approach 5 such people, you get your initial, you know, ticket size funding of 1 crore, which is enough to show that what you can do in this money. If you can scale up in this money, there will be hundreds of investors running towards you. In fact, these people, your first initial investors, will again come back. They will tell, okay, Amit ji, why don't you take more funds? Like, this is how it happens. But the mistake, especially founders do, is they think zyada funding chahiye. We need 5 crores, 6 crores, 10 crores, 100 crores. That is the wrong way. It is okay. It is okay to take more funding, right? It is nothing bad, because money is required for business. But it is not okay to take the funding so much, or asking for it in initial period, right? Take say 25 lakhs, 50 lakhs, utilize that money. Like, I'll tell you, we always say in this line, especially in startups, which is the most important currency? Somebody says, you know, dollar, Bitcoin, euros. No. Reputation is the most precious currency in the world in today's time.
Right.
If you build the reputation by just say 25 lakhs, 50 lakhs, right? Some founders tell me, Shishir, this is like 50 lakh, to main chewing gum khake phook deta hu. So it does not matter, right? There are founders, I will not take the name, there is a founder from, you know, a very big group in Bhubaneswar. And he said, Shishir, 50 lakh is something like, you know, it's not even respecting me. I said, sir, don't look at 50 lakhs. Look at, you are getting somebody's money, and if you are utilizing this money in the right way, they will be happy to give you 10 times more money. But you have to start from somewhere, right? So that is, if you don't have a previous experience of raising funds from angel investors, then you are a fresher in the industry. Being a fresher, you have to go step by step. Take 25 lakh, which is the minimum investment. And we are doing these kind of demo days very soon. Again, demo day is coming in 15 days. There, we will pick up 10 founders like you, right? Who are doing real business, who are making money, revenue.
Actually.
Right? And the other side, we invite investors. We tell them, you know, hear them out and understand what kind of business they are doing and what kind of scalability they can achieve later on, provided you fund them, right? And we ask our investors to put in a very small amount, 2.5 lakh rupees. So 10 investors can fund one startup in one event itself, or maybe 5-6 startups, right? 2.5 lakh rupees for a person who's, you know, making good is not big amount. And that is how we build the first round. And if that round happens, if you are in this, another one thing is very important. If you are able to raise one time, then you can raise again. Okay.
There is a question, like, in case, you know, we take a funding of say 50 lakh rupees, but actually the fund which was required for us, say 3-3.5 crores, right? So we start building our company with those 50 lakh rupees. But once those 50 lakhs are exhausted, how sure are we that we will be able to get another 50 lakhs or 1 crore?
100%, be sure, 100%. If you are able to raise 50 lakhs, you will be able to raise 5 crores, then you will be able to raise 50 crores.
The challenge is, agar wo nahi hua, to
main karunga. I am there for you, I guarantee. On public call, I am telling you, recorded session, write it down on stamp paper, I can challenge it.
Achha.
If you are able to utilize that money in the right way,
yes,
money is everywhere. Then comes the VCs, institutions are there. They have public money. We don't understand, you know, sometimes we don't even think about what is VC money. Mm-hmm. VC money is the money which is raised from annuity fund, right? 1% of the US annuity, PPF, LICs, kind of.
Achha.
So long term, 50 saal ka jo fund hai, in US, if you take 1% out of it, it is huge.
Right.
It is really huge.
Right.
And
right.
That the government allows them to invest 1% of that amount to high risk securities. Because high risk equal to high return. So these VCs, they don't have their own money, but they have an objective. It is like a rule book, right? Like a lawyer and judge. I'm a lawyer, I'll tell you. Like a lawyer and judge, they speak the same language. Lawyer can't do anything on its own. Judge can't do anything on its own.
Correct.
They have to abide by the rule book. Similarly, VCs have their rule book. They have the objective, everything is written. And it is as good as mathematics. You give me 2 plus 2, they will give you 4.
So what you are trying to tell me is, one thing is absolutely straight. If we get started with funding somehow, and if we are able to utilize that funding in the right way, or what we promise, then there is no looking back. We are
visualize yourself. There was a Nasiruddin Shah movie, you know, where he used to have legacy, and they asked him, you know, we will give you money only if you are able to spend 1 crore, but you don't have to buy assets.
Huh.
Have you seen that? Actually, this is the real life of funding. Reality. You don't have to buy assets. If you are able to utilize this 50 lakhs.
Huh.
Right, and create revenue out of it.
Mm.
If you multiply this money, then you can, you know, take enormous amount of fund, enormous.
That's given.
Provided that you have the equity level.
Right.
You don't have to throw away the equity. Right. So
and how do we get the guidance over how much equity and how to take care of
it? We have everything. We have spent 6 good years in startups, you know. In venture capital, investment banking, everything is there. Startup Lanes can help you end to end with everything. Right? So, whether it is the term sheets, whether it is the venture capital, angel investment, it is all about from your idea to IPO, we have everything. From idea to IPO. So, once you are in between say, flight going Mumbai to Delhi, and you are in between, you know, catching it in Jaipur, then also we are going in the same direction.
Right.
Our end line is IPO.
Right.
And this is what we are trying to do. We are trying to at least give this vision to everyone, especially the entrepreneurs, to dream big, aim big, because this is the time. This time has never come ever in the life of India. And this will never come ever in the life of India again. This is the best time for us. What has happened in US in 70s is happening in India right now.
Right.
Investor, wo kabar se nikal ke aa rahe. Everybody is, you know, mare hue zinda ho rahe. This is actually the reality. People are ready to invest immediately. Right? India's growth story is the best in the world. 12% growth. But agar abhi bhi paisa nahi mila, to kabhi nahi milega. Because it's all about, then it is not about finding the investors. Technically, it is not about finding the investors. I'm very telling you very true. In India, every person, even a common man, has a fixed deposit of 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakh, 4 lakh. Common men also have. Like, we are not able to beat the inflation also. Like, 5% FD return and inflation, you can't beat FD, you know, inflation with the FD. Still, we are keeping that money in the FD. We are afraid because, again, this system is not very trustworthy as of now.
Okay.
These lot of scammers have scammed the common man and people, even the investors, you know, even the educated people, they don't understand what is angel investing. We tell them that we'll give you 18%, 24% fixed return. And from those companies which are good, ready, settled, there are entrepreneurs who have been doing since generations. Right, there are entrepreneurs who have been doing business, father and grandfather and grandfather's grandfather.
Correct.
Right, and they have the legacy. So investing, technically investing 5 lakh, 10 lakhs with such kind of businesses is never bad. if they are giving you the fixed return. Somebody having shop in the Khari Babuli, if investor invest 5 lakh rupees with such guy, I don't think there is a risk. I don't think. So that is what we are doing. We are doing these road shows, events with the investors. We are explaining them. We are creating their communities, telling them what kind of benefits, and also the most important thing, we are telling them your money should not go into the bank and gone to the Malayas. Your money should go to the common man, entrepreneurs who are building the nation, creating the jobs.
Correct, correct.
And we are doing this at our best, and this is happening, thank God. Thanks to the system of, thanks to, I will not say BJP or any government, but thanks to whatever is happening in the country, this is happening. This new wave of nationalism has come up. So everybody is patriotic right now. They want to do something for their nation.
Absolutely. And absolutely.
We have to scale it up. We have to just stick to this. Everybody is believing and trusting upon our people. This time is changing. Earlier that was happening. People were thinking ki videshi hai to achha hai, foreign good is good. Right? Import from America, Americans, or expensive is good. No. Now this is changing. I was in the morning, I just went to buy some flowers for puja, and I saw packets of these fruits and vegetables in bulk quantities for distribution. And then I realized there is a new startup on the block. They are supplying directly from the farms to the houses.
Achha.
And they were more than 5,000 packets I saw. So you can imagine 5,000 houses. Wow. 5,000 families at least receiving at one particular location, and a startup is doing it, and this was not Amazon, a new blog, new startup that came, and they are doing it very nicely. Okay. So this is the story. India is changing, and we should be really proud and happy about it.
Right.
And we are there. We are there to support at all the levels.
Thanks. All right. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Pleasure. Okay. All right. Anjali, next question.
Vishal Rawal, you can go next.
Hi, good evening. First of all, we are very thankful to Startup Lens and Shishir ji, you. I am regular following you, your social media handles, really inspiring. And आप ये जो सेशन ले रहे हैं ये भी बहुत ही इंस्पायरिंग है. और हम जैसे जो जॉब करते थे पहले और अभी एक एंटरप्रेन्योर्स बन चुके हैं उनके लिए बहुत ही मोटिवेशनल है.
बस सर, आप सब लोगों की कृपा है. व्हाटएवर वी हैव गॉट, दिस इज बिकॉज़ ऑफ योर लव एंड सपोर्ट.
यस सर. मैं मायसेल्फ इज विशाल रावल. मैं टेक्नो कमर्शियल पर्सन हूँ. मैं पिछले 20 सालों से मीडिया एंड टेक्नोलॉजी में बहुत काम कर चुका हूँ. बड़ी बड़ी एमएनसी कंपनी में काम कर चुका हूँ. अभी मैं जस्ट दिवाली पे मैंने सब कुछ छोड़ के खुद का काम शुरू किया है लाइक एंटरप्रेन्योर. तो अभी दो चीजें मैं आपसे पूछना चाहूंगा. पहली चीज, मेरी ऑलरेडी 8 साल से एक ऑलरेडी कंपनी चल रही थी जिसको मैं ध्यान नहीं रखा था. मेरे ब्रदर और ये सब कर रहे थे काम, लेकिन नाउ आई एम इनटू फुल फ्लैश इनटू दैट. दैट इज अबाउट द केबल टीवी एंड इंटरनेट सर्विस प्रोवाइडिंग इन गुजरात. ओके, सो एक स्टेज पर ये अभी कंपनी है. एक पर्टिकुलर सिटी पे हम सर्विस प्रोवाइड करते हैं जहाँ पर अप्रोक्सीमेटली 25-1 लाख रुपए का एक सालाना टर्नओवर मतलब सालाना सेल्स है मेरा. तो अभी मैं इसको एक एक्सपेंशन मोड में ले जाना चाहता हूँ. तो इन दैट कंडीशन हाउ कैन आई गेट, क्योंकि आज तक खुद के पैसे से ही काम किया, किसी और के पैसे से काम नहीं किया, इसलिए थोड़ा डर भी लगता है. क्योंकि एक बेसिक मेंटेलिटी की बात कर रहा हूँ, ह्यूमन मेंटेलिटी, कि आज मैं किसी और से पैसा उधार लेता हूँ तो उसमें दो डर होते हैं. एक तो यार उसका कंट्रोल मेरे पे हो जाएगा, मेरे काम पे हो जाएगा, या फिर वो कभी भी मुझे कुछ भी बोल सकता है. दिस इज द बेसिक देसी मेंटेलिटी विच एवरीवन, आई एम प्राउड टू एक्सेप्ट दीज थिंग्स बिकॉज एवरीवन हैज दिस ऑन देयर इन देयर माइंड्स. एंड इस ये क्वेश्चन एक बार आप थोड़ा सा एलोबरेट करें, मतलब इसका आंसर मुझे एलोबरेट करें, उसके बाद मैं दूसरा क्वेश्चन प्लीज शेयर करूंगा.
मैं फिर से आपको सेकंड क्वेश्चन का आंसर पहले दूंगा. कोई भी इन्वेस्टर आप पे कोई भी कंट्रोल नहीं कर पाएगा
जी.
कभी भी नहीं कर पाएगा, ठीक है, अनटिल एंड अनलेस यू गिव दैट कंट्रोल.
ओके,
दिस डिपेंड्स एंटायरली अपॉन द टर्म शीट वेयर टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस आर एस्टैब्लिश्ड. सो इफ यू गिव एन इन्वेस्टर rights into the management or director's position, then it's your call, but nobody will ask for it.
Okay.
Second is, while you want to raise funds for a conventional business, businesses are, वैसे तो बहुत सारी category है, but दो category में divide करते हैं, conventional और innovational. तो अगर innovation वाला business है, तो innovation भी बताता हूँ मैं आपको क्या है. Conventional business होता है जो चला आ रहा है. This is more of, you know, this gives you steady returns, but not very fast growth.
आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द एक्सपेंशन ऑफ, मतलब आज क्या हो रहा है, हम लोग जो काम कर रहे हैं वो पर्टिकुलर सिटी में पर्टिकुलर जोन में एक कंपनी के साथ एग्रीमेंट में काम कर रहे
हैं. नहीं सर, मैं आपको अपॉर्चुनिटी, आई विल टेल यू एन एग्जांपल, मैं एग्जांपल से बताता हूं, आपको समझ आ जाएगा. ठीक है, अगर आप इंडियन रेलवेज की जो मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी स्पीड है कितनी है, शायद 140 होगी या 160 होगी, है ना.
ओके,
तो आप वही वाली ट्रेन को आप बोलते हो कि आज ये ट्रेन चलती है दिल्ली टू कानपुर, मैं इसको दिल्ली टू मुंबई ले जाऊंगा, या फिर ऐसी एक और चलाऊंगा. okay. उसकी मैक्स स्पीड क्या है? मैक्स स्पीड 180 है, 160 होती रहेगी ना
जी.
आपने इंजन भी तेज बना लिया, बट आगे जो उसकी ट्रेन चल रही है वो स्लो है, फिर आप क्या करेंगे
जी?
राइट, सो एज एन इन्वेस्टर, इफ समबडी सेज देयर आर टू चॉइसेस, इन्वेस्ट into the speed of 160 or invest into the speed of this private jet, investor will definitely put in money into the private jet.
Okay.
And it is nothing bad. Indian Railway छोटी नहीं हो जाती उससे. Indian Railway बहुत महान है अपने आप में. But in comparison, that is faster. You getting my point?
Okay.
So, as an investor, when you have choices, you will pick up the best one, most innovative one. Why? Because of late in the past, technology companies have created wealth for the investors, and this is in last 30 years. Right? Google, Amazon, all these companies have been tech companies. Because what happens with the technology? Tech brings in efficiency, convenience, and that is most important thing. Efficiency, yani aapko कम पैसा लगा के या कम इनपुट दे के ज्यादा आउटपुट मिल रहा है, ऑप्टिमाइज आउटपुट मिल रहा है, देन इट इज बेटर. राइट, सो पुराना जाएगा नया आएगा. आपको सोचना है कि मैं इसमें बेटर क्या कर सकता हूँ, व्हाट कैन आई डू टू मेक दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इनोवेटिव, व्हाट एम आई डिलीवरिंग विच आर नॉट डिलीवर्ड बाय अदर्स, एंड देन यू हैव टू डू अ कंपैरिजन चार्ट. राइट, कंपेयर योरसेल्फ विद नेटफ्लिक्स, compare yourself with Amazon, compare yourself with Dish TV, and I'm sure you will find lot of points which you can win through the competition. I'll tell you why. आपने वो चाय वाला तो देखा होगा जो you know mall के आसपास में मिलता है, and there are chayos, cafe coffee days, lot of restaurants, you know, good hygienic, they are offering for 20 rupees, and chai wala is offering for 10 rupees, sometimes 20 also. Still people are coming to the chai wala to have the tea. अब उसके अपने कुछ benefits हैं और उसके कुछ अपने benefits हैं. क्या क्या benefit हैं? चाय वाला बाहर ही मिल गया, convenience, you don't have to park the car. चाय वाला is customizable, you can see what you are, what he is making. For some people, they enjoy the process of watching it. Some people, they enjoy how this is being made, and they can you know add and remove things according to them. So everybody in this world has their own USP, and then this roadside chai wala can also innovate and create something better than chai also. So what I'm trying to tell you is, you might be having lot of USPs, you have to identify and innovate and depict how you can scale up very fast. जो आप कर रहे हो वो करते करते तो शायद नहीं होगा.
But sir, don't you think the expansion is also the adding some worth into the company? जैसा आज मैं आज suppose 10 किलोमीटर में काम कर रहा हूँ और मुझे fundraising करना है कि मैं इस मेरा 10 किलोमीटर को 100 किलोमीटर में काम करूँगा मैं. तो is it not worthy?
No, it is worthy. कोई भी efforts खराब नहीं होते. But stock market में आपको पैसा डालना है ना? ये तो shares ही खरीदेंगे sir.
जी.
आपने स्टॉक मार्केट में पैसा डालना है तो आप कैसे चूज करते हो कंपनी?
कंपनी का बैकग्राउंड, उसका सेल्स, उसका सर्विसेज, उसका अपकमिंग प्रोजेक्शंस,
है ना. अब आपको टू कंपनीज मिल गई, एक मिल गई एशियन पेंट्स और एक मिल गई टाटा मोटर्स. अब एशियन पेंट्स बहुत फास्ट ग्रोथ कर रही है और टाटा मोटर्स में आपको लग रहा है कि इन्होंने बहुत डेब्ट लिया हुआ है, उधार लिया हुआ है
जी,
और ये नहीं चल पाएगी. तो आप फिर क्या करेंगे?
Obviously, जहां पर potentiality, किसी से consult करूंगा और फिर उसमें share करूंगा किसी में,
है ना. तो most probably, most likely आप Asian Paints में पैसे डाल देंगे अगर आपको buy करना है. And this is what I'm trying to tell you is, उससे Tata Motors बुरा नहीं हो जाता. Everything is good, but the funding will go to the better one.
Okay.
Right. So okay. If there are 30 students in the class, only one is the monitor or one is the class leader, that means, or one is the topper, you know, that will take the attention.
Are you trying to say कि expansion area expansion के लिए funding generally लोग select नहीं करते हैं उसमें कुछ innovation साथ में हो जाए like OTT platform में घर घर तक FTTH के through पहुंचाना के plan कर सकता हूँ तो मुझे funding मिल सकता है
जी नहीं दोनों चीजों में आपकी funding हमेशा मिल सकती है okay. आपको size पे depend करता है if you are into a conventional business
okay
and you are looking for more than 100 crore of funding then it is very easy but for having more than 100 crore of funding you need to have more than 100 crore of revenue
true
but conventional business and small funding not possible
okay
because us revenue based hai sara aur conventional business more funding very possible because now it is established business
yes
aur choti funding chahiye to aapko bahut zyada innovative business chahiye because This has initial छोटी funding वाली जो startup है उनका revenue कम होता है उसमें risk का risk बहुत ज़्यादा होता है so investors want to invest into the best one but when it reaches the same stage when everybody is a unicorn or maybe beyond that a corporate established mammoth company then you don't have to worry about like banks don't worry about फिर तो क्या है stable उनको पता है इतना पैसा तो ये चुका ही देंगे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता चाहे वो debt में दें या equity में दें
Okay.
But especially at the small stage, you have to be very much innovative. Innovative में भी आपको ये दिखाना है कि मेरा growth कैसे आ जाएगा. Why I you will be able to the acquisition per customer over the period of time
yes.
has to be higher than the industry. Suppose okay. your competitors are able to acquire 100 customers in 1 month. Mm-hmm. If you are able to acquire 500 customers in 1 month, you get the funding.
Okay, that is there. That is there. I was talking about that only. Because वहाँ पर क्या सिचुएशन अगर चार कॉम्पिटिटर है मेरे जहाँ पर दो कॉम्पिटिटर वॉन्ट टू सेल आउट द होल थिंग्स टू मी ओनली एंड ऑल्सो देर आर दी अनटच्ड एरिया वेयर द सर्विस इशू एंड वी हैव द वेरी गुड टीम ऑफ सर्विस टेक्निकल टीम जो वहाँ पर मैं एक्सपेंशन मोड में जा सकता हूँ तो वो सब प्लस पॉइंट्स हैं
मेरे इफ यू आर गेटिंग 85% ऑफ योर बिजनेस थ्रू रेफरेंस न्यू बिजनेस की बात कर रहा
हूँ हाँ रेफरेंस यस
अगर आपको 85% बिजनेस आ रहा है रेफरेंस से तो आपकी 100% फंडिंग हो जाएगी अभी
चलो ग्रेट बस
तो आपको अभी एक अच्छी सी पिच डेक बनानी है इसीलिए क्या होता है पिच डेक बनाते हैं पिच डेक डिपिक्ट्स एवरीथिंग सो यू गो टू स्टार्टअप प्लेस देयर इज अ पेज
ओके
फंडिंग वाले पेज पे आप जाइए एंड अप्लाई कर दीजिए पिच डेक आपके पास होनी चाहिए एंड इफ द पिच डेक इज गुड यू विल हैव टू पिच टू आवर टीम इफ दे आर सैटिस्फाइड दे विल पुट यू थ्रू द इन्वेस्टर्स
ओके ग्रेट सेकंड क्वेश्चन सर मेरा मैंने देर आर सम आइडियाज तो मैं एक आइडिया मैंने एजुकेशन लेवल पे लेके गया हूँ जहाँ पर 85% मेरा प्रोडक्ट रेडी हो चुका है 15% बाकी है ड्यू टू दी फंडिंग इशू मतलब वो फंड इन्वेस्ट करना पड़ेगा तो मेरे को एप्लीकेशन और हार्डवेयर इंटीग्रेशन वगैरह सब हो पाएगा दूसरा आइडिया है वो केवल और केवल थॉट पर है थॉट और डॉक्यूमेंटेशन पर है तो इन दोनों कंडीशन के अंदर मुझे क्या पेटेंट करवा के फिर फंडिंग और किसी के थ्रू आगे बढ़ना चाहिए या फिर दोनों लेवल पर मैं किस लेवल मतलब किस आइडिया को थॉट को मेरे को इमीडिएट फंडिंग मिल सकता है
आपको अगर पेटेंट नहीं कराया तो इन्वेस्टर्स एक्सटर्नल इन्वेस्टर्स जो आपको नहीं जानते उनको अप्रोच भी नहीं करना चाहिए
ओके
बिकॉज अगर सच में अच्छा कुछ बना रहे हैं आप
यस इट इज रियली रेयर
यू हैव द रिस्क ऑफ लूजिंग आउट द आइडिया
ओके
So at this stage, you need to approach your friends and family members.
Okay.
And there comes again, jo maine last mein kaha tha, reputation is your
yes.
most precious currency. Aur aapko zarurat nahi bhi ho, to friends and family se thode thode paise leke reputation banana shuru kar dijiye. Because okay. if you have returned the money on time with yes. some appreciation, yes. then they will give you back again and again.
True.
And that is the best way we ignore it. Sometimes we ignore it. वो भूल जाते हैं हम और वहां गलती हो जाती है बिकॉज फ्रेंड्स एंड फैमिली से जो पैसा आ जाता है उसको बहुत इंपॉर्टेंस देता है एक्सटर्नल इन्वेस्टर भी
ओके
अगर आप एक्सटर्नल इन्वेस्टर पे जाओगे वो पूछेगा आपने अपने फ्रेंड से कितना और फैमिली से कितना रेस किया आपने बोला जीरो तो उससे ये भी डिपेंड होता है कि जब आपके फ्रेंड्स एंड फैमिली आप पे विश्वास नहीं करते तो बाहर वाले कैसे करेंगे तो वी हैव टू बिल्ड, छोटा पैसा लो, कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, थोड़ा थोड़ा लो और यू टेक द मनी एंड टेल देम कि भाई मेरा एक्सटर्नल इन्वेस्टर आएगा और मैं आपको पैसा वापस करता हूँ. राइट, सो एटलीस्ट यू दिस डिपिक्ट्स द ट्रस्ट, बिकॉज मनी उधार एक दिन का मिला, 10 दिन का मिला, 500 दिन का मिला, ट्रस्ट उतनी ही मिलती है.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. एंड द सर थिंक दैट जो मैं आपसे एक क्वेश्चन पूछा था कि थॉट पर फंडिंग इजी हो सकता है बेस्ट, मैं ऑब्वियसली इट्स डिपेंड्स ऑन द डॉक्यूमेंटेशन, या फिर जो मेरा अभी एक 85% एक प्रोडक्ट रेडी है, 15% पेंडिंग है, तो उस पर मैं ज्यादा मेहनत करके.
नहीं सर, आइडिया पे कभी फंडिंग नहीं लेना ना मांगना, बिकॉज मेरे पास रोज 500 लोग आते हैं जो बोलते हैं फेसबुक मेरा आइडिया था. राइट, सो नोबडी नोस आइडिया किसका था, इट्स नॉट अबाउट आइडिया,
इट पेटेंटेड.
It is about the execution.
Okay,
चांद पे तो सबको जाना है, जाता कौन है वो इम्पोर्टेंट.
Very thankful to you, sir. Nice to talk to you. Really inspirational. और जरूर जो आपने मुझे बताया उस पर मैं थोड़ा वर्क करके खुद को भी इम्प्रूव करूंगा और वेरी सुन वी आर कम अप विद द डॉक्यूमेंटेशन टू स्टार्ट अ प्लेस. थैंक यू
प्लीज, अगली बार फिर से आइएगा, we'll do this again.
Also, I refer my so many friends टेक्नोलॉजी में जो है जो ये करना चाहते हैं जिसका आप इंस्पिरेशन बन सकते हैं सर, जरूर मैं रेफर करूंगा उनको भी और मैं खुद भी आऊंगा.
So nice of you, so kind of you. Thank you. Next question, please.
Anjali, who's next?
Hardik Sisodia, you can go next. Oh, hi, Hardik this side. First of all, I'd like to thank you for this, for conducting this amazing session. Hello?
Yeah, I'm listening.
Sorry, So anyways, I'll just quickly start off with the question part. I'm a startup and I recently launched to my brand actually. Which actually is not properly launched yet, but I'm still working out on it. Okay, and the thing which I'm trying to make is an AI. Okay, and this basically deals with fitness and human health and wellness. So basically, I'm trying to cover the 8 dimensions of wellness in this program. Now, what I wanted to ask is, like, how are we supposed to set a target market? Like how are we supposed to conduct a market survey if we have a data or if we don't even have a data properly and we need the data, and that data, that particular data of a particular user is quite expensive or maybe very sensitive information. So how are we supposed to conduct those kind of surveys?
Okay, so first you need to identify your potential customers. And then you have to identify a small sample size, 10, 15, 20, whatever it is, and then create surveys. In those surveys, understand it has to be based upon the problems. Understand if we solve your problem, first of all, they need to confirm that they are facing that problem. If they don't confirm that they are facing the problem, it is useless. But if they say, we are facing the problem, I'll give you an example. Say, you know, lot of parents are concerned about their kids playing outside while they are at home. And the kids, you know, there is a safety concern. So if you approach those parents and ask them, are you concerned about it? They must confirm. If they confirm, then you have got your sample data. From that sample, you need to have a questionnaire signed. Ask them few questions. Most important questions are whether you will use the solution, for how long you will use the solution. This will give you the lifetime value, for how much price you will be ready to pay, for how much price you will be buying this solution. This will give you the appropriate price. And if you get people for longer period of time, good lifetime value, good price, then you have to find out what would be the acquisition cost of these customers. If CAC is to LTV, the ratio is very attractive. That means cost of acquisition is low and lifetime value of a customer is very high. Example, if you are acquiring a nursery kid to a school which is up to class 12 for rupees 60 rupees per lead, right? And the conversion is say 5 out of 1 converts, then it is a very good proposition. Multiply this, you know, total 5 you spend, 3,300 rupees, you get one student who will be paying off say 1 lakh rupees for 12 years. 12 lakh lifetime value. So if this goes well, then definitely you have to get into that. But if these numbers are not depicting anything which is suitable, then ignore it and try something else. And you have to do A, B, C, three types of things. Accordingly, okay, you will also get your first customers. Because those who said, I will suppose, you know, if somebody said, okay, give me this solution, I will buy it for 3 years and I'll pay X rupees. And if you give them the solution, they will buy it for 3 years and they will give you X rupees. Right? So you got get your initial customers as well through this survey. And if this works, go for it. Right? Any follow-up question you have for that?
Yes, I not the follow-up questions. I also have some more questions regards to the funding part. I recently, like, whatever the money I'm spending right now is from my pocket itself. Whatever the funding I have done is from my pocket itself. So what is actually the right time or the best stage to get a startup funded? Like, when should we go for investors? When should we go for get funded? When is the very right time to do that?
So, I'll give you a ballpark figure. Do not raise more than 10%. Right? That means if your company is valued at 1 crore, do not raise more than 10 lakh, because in the first round, you will end up throwing away equity. You should not give away more equity initially, because initially your valuation will be low. That means you should not take much money. If possible, keep your needs under 25 lakhs and divide it into three tranches: 5 lakh, 5 lakh, or maybe 10 lakh, 15 lakhs, or maybe 10, 10, 5, whatever it is, if it is possible. Because three magical things are going to happen. One, this will build the investor's confidence. You will easily get funded. Second, you will be able to, if you are able to utilize small money, then you will definitely be able to utilize big money. Those organizations, especially the startups, are not good, which are not able to utilize small money, because that shows your efficiency is low, or you are investing into long-term asset building process. Say, if you have to buy a machinery, or if you have to build a constructor building, take an example of hotel, 5-star hotel. This will require hundreds of crores rupees, right? Investors are not ready to go for this. Investors are ready to fund, a business which can utilize small money as less as 5,000 rupees and get some revenue out of it. Especially the internet companies, they have this structure where you have a clear CAC is to LTV. If you are able to acquire customers digitally, and this brings revenue, say anything, if I'm selling a course maybe. So if I'm able to acquire a customer for 100 rupees and if I sell a course for 1000, this is a model. Every investor will be happily putting in money into this kind of model. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Pleasure. Anjali, next question.
Mohit Mishra, you can go next.
Hello.
Yeah, hi Mohit.
Hi, and thank you for this opportunity. I would like to ask the question. Actually, my startup is in seed stage, and right now we are two partners and we are working on it. So I am he is an IT guy and he is looking after all the technical parts, and rest I am looking after. So right now the thing is, whatever we have, the money we have spent to grow it, take it to the stage where it is right now. And right now we want funds. So what is the best approach to the investor? Like, whom should we approach, either the angel investor or the venture capitalist at this stage? And what will be the best approach for it?
Okay. See, like I was telling earlier, the first round should happen from 3 F: friends, family and fools. Friends, you understand, family, you understand. Fools are the people who trust you very initially, right?
Yes.
So if you are able to raise from them, let it be the small amount. And this could be 5 lakhs, 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs, okay. And if you are able to utilize that amount in the right way, then you have to go and approach the angel investors. But the right time to approach an angel investor ideally is when you have revenue more than 50,000 per month at least. Or if it is, you know, a startup which is like WhatsApp, which might not have revenue, or Quora, which might not have revenue for say years to come, but it is depicting that, you know, this could scale up to very large because it is collecting data. Cred is a very good example. I hope everybody is aware about Cred. Cred is a very good example. This is highly funded. Their revenue is almost nothing. Nothing means nothing. But they are sitting on the gold mine of data. So such companies can get funded very easily because data is the new oil. Everybody understand if they are building the data, they can cash out that data anytime. But if you are not building that kind of data and the user base, and then you are asking for funding, you must have the revenue, right? So that is most important, and your valuation should support what you are going for. Second round, you can go for the angel funding. VCs is a big no-no. If you don't have taken the funding from angel investors, don't approach VCs unless your revenues are approaching 50 to 20 lakh rupees a month minimum.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah. Thank Great. You.
Next question.
Ashish Pandey has asked a question on debt. How to value my company?
Can you come again with the question? No, I'm not able to hear that.
How to value my company and what kind of equity I can dilute? Ashish Pandey has asked.
The valuation, there are 9 methods of valuation, and I have propounded the 10th method called fair share method of valuation, which is based upon A to Z 26 points. So I do the valuation on the fair share method, which has which considers your lot of 26 points, that is your team, the management capabilities of the teams, then the idea itself, the disruption element, your competition, your SWOT analysis, industry itself, how fast the market is going, then about, you know, the product, what kind of product it is, pricing, social media reviews, then future expected revenue, what kind of, how your competitors are doing, any unfair advantage you have, the kind of problem you are solving, the degree of the solution, you know, use of technology, then your intellectual property, like patent and trademarks. So it's a combination of all these. And you know, this is something very complex that we do at Startup Place through our investment banking team, and we give weights to all of these things, and on the basis of the weights to these points we derive a value. So it's not, you know, as easy as it seems. So I cannot completely explain this in this one particular small session. It is something, you know, that will take lot of couple of sessions, but definitely I'll try to. I'm you know, authoring this second part of my book called Funding Startup Easy Part 2 Funding. So might be, you know, I'll be able to depict everything in that. Okay, next question please.
Mayank Sharma, your question.
Hi Shishir. So we are a team of 3 co-founders, and what we are building is a AIML based investment tool. So like it will help you, it's an automated tool which will help you invest in mutual funds and other financial assets. So we are currently at a POC stage, and the issue we are facing is to make it to the MVP level that we can put it in the market. There are few compliances from financial perspective. Like for SEBI, there's a regulation for RIA, registered investment advisor. So how can we pass through these kind of hurdles and connect to the market?
The best way is to sign up with them. I think you have to lower your volume. it's echoing. The best way is to sign up with a partner who already have these kind of licenses and go for a fixed kind of contract. You know, if you don't have the amount to pay as of now, you can pay them an equity swap or one side equity arrangement, right? So, but you need to go for a contract. You need to have your intellectual property agreements in place. You need to have your patents, your IP must be protected before you approach such kind of investor or the partner, right? Why I'm saying investor? Because even investing in terms of capabilities, time and resources, except money, is also an investment. And there are so many people available who have existing licenses, right? So you can utilize those licenses. They don't have to pay extra for it. And there are so many financial companies. They might be able to give you, and you can utilize them as your lab. Once it is done, you can pay them in a fixed amount of equity or maybe a fixed amount of price post your funding. And that's the best way to go about it. I'm telling you, because approaching RBI and SEBI is a very, very tedious task. I'm not saying things don't work, but it will take away your precious time that you should focus upon building your product.
Thanks for that. And so, we have a follow-up question. So if we are at a POC stage, okay, and like MVP for us would be in around 2 or 3 months. So what is the probability of getting an angel investor or to get a seed fund? What approaches can we take up?
See, getting seed fund or maybe technically it is a pre-seed funding. Getting such kind of funding on the basis of MVP is a bit difficult process, to be honest. This kind of funding only comes from the people you know. This is the reality of it, right? So unknown people might not be able to put in money until and unless you have a very proven record. Like if you have, say, you know, I have done this in the past, I have given the exit of so and so amount to the investors, or maybe I was a topper throughout from IITs and all that. If you don't have that kind of track record, which generally not everybody has, right? Then in that case, you need to approach people you know and take smaller amounts of funding, not the bigger amounts, and engage more people initially. Right? You cannot have crores of money coming in from everyone. But yes, if you get an introduction properly, say maybe somebody, your college professor know you, then he introduce you to the chairman of the college and the college chairman puts in some money. This way this can work. Else, from unknown people who are just investors, they invest purely for money, they will not invest. This is something which is true.
Thanks for that.
So, Ashishir, so even if we have something like a product has really good capability and is currently, you know, not too much into the market, like people have started doing it, but at a very nascent stage it is in the market, and we have the capability of providing that, even then you would say that the pre-seed funding would be difficult from investors.
So I try to, you know, inflate an example for you, and it is inflated and exaggerated. If somebody sells you an iPhone, latest iPhone, just, you know, outside the train you come out at the railway station, you might not believe that guy, right? No matter, this might be the genuine phone. No matter. He will show you an invoice. He will show you, sir, I have an invoice. Somebody picked up my pocket and I just need your help, right? But you will not trust that guy because of the past experiences, because of the market, right? Because what happens. So I'm not saying that iPhone is bad. You understand? I'm not saying your product would be good. Everything will be fine. But getting money from people who don't know you at an MVP stage is really, really a bad idea. This is going to waste your time. But yes, you can focus your energies on people you know, or at least through references, because they need to, somebody has to vouch. Somebody has to say, I know this guy. I can definitely, take the guarantee that this guy will not waste your money, or maybe, you know, will utilize it well. Right? So that is okay. But technically, angels are not angels. They are businessmen. And they need to invest to get the returns. Isn't it? So that's what the process is. You need to focus entirely upon people who you know, they know you or somebody as a mediator can vouch you, right? And do not believe on people who are into industry or investment banking or maybe angel investors or maybe venture capitalists, right? Also me, don't believe on me if I say I can vouch you. You understand? Because technically it is against the business that we are doing. If I start vouching for unknown people, then we are cheating our investors, right? Technically we don't know each other. How can I vouch you? So only either your mama ji, your chacha ji, your college professors, your mother, father, these are the people they will vouch for you. And that is how everybody has raised funds, right? Else, it is the only other way. If you have the certification, that means, you know, whatever you have done in life has been on top, then anybody will trust. Oh, you are the IIT topper, go for it. But if not, then don't go for it.
Thanks for that info.
Do we have more questions?
Yes, sir. Ravi Sharma, you can go next.
Just you have to give me 2-3 minutes. Because time is over and somebody is calling me again and again. So I will definitely answer all the questions. Just give me 2 minutes break.
Or should I hold?
Yeah, I'm back. I can take two more questions because I have to rush for something.
Okay, so I'll be very, very brief. I think most of the questions which Mr. Amit Jain were asked, you answered all those questions. So I'll be very, very brief. My idea of the business, with the startup which I'm doing it, I have taken the share of one of the organization which my friend was running from last 13, 14 years. And I've been associated with this company from last 3 years. The idea is not very new, but it is very proven and tested. However, everyone does not have the intelligence to run, you know, that kind of a business, and we are running it. Since 3 years, the growth of this business has been more than 100% every year. Now, when I took over, or when I get the, you know, the startup of this or the new business venture with this this idea, my revenue was start approximately 2 lakh rupees. Now I'm clocking 20 lakh rupees per month. So growth has been very, very nice. Customer base, I've grown every year 100%. I mean, as of now, when I started in the beginning, I'm having more than 100% growth as of today. You gave one idea in between while talking to other people that you should raise the fund with friends, family and fools. So that we have done it, and growth has been very nice and they are happy and we are still associated. Now the last part is, we want to this business which I am doing it, I am doing it in the domestic level at Delhi and NCR level. However, this business has a very exponential growth internationally and internationally, which we want to do the expansion, where we require the actual funding, because we need to build the infrastructure, we need to research and to put the money in the marketing and everything. So my question is, when I should start thinking about the, you know, talking about the taking the investment from other outside of my own network. So that's my first question. When or with whom I should start talking to it?
Immediately you have to take the money, because like we discussed, no company can become big without external funding. There are stages to it. You have, if you reach out those stages and raise funding at the right time,
okay,
it is always good for you. So first raise, like you have completed the stage of 3F, now it is the time to raise angel funding, then VC funding, then PE, then pre-IPO funding from a VC like Trifecta, and then IPO. Like this is that entire process, and then after IPO you will be raising from banks the big ticket size.
How should I calculate that? What kind of percentage I should look forward for the investment?
See, but those things are called, you know, valuations, term sheets. These are all done by the professionals.
I see.
Thankfully, at Startup Planes, we have end-to-end entire solution for you. But this is a chargeable solution, so you need to do your maths well and find out you have the budget for valuations. Valuation minimum charges starts from 25,000, right? And the average for particularly $1 million valuation startup is like 75,000. I need to check that. I'm not having the ready reckoner with me right now. But valuation, if you get it done, don't get it done through a chartered accountant. I'm so sorry I'm saying that. Through a chartered accountant who is not having the experience of investment banking, especially the startups, right? So generally, they follow a practice which is not suitable for startups. They follow a practice which values the assets. And sometimes, in fact, most of the time, startups don't have the assets, the hard assets I'm talking about. So if you don't have such kind of fixed assets, then you will not be able to get your good valuation through those accounting systems. So you have to go through the modern accounting approach, which calculates, like I told you, your competition, disruption element, your team's capabilities, your intellectual property. And these are not hard assets, but these assets matter the most. Like in terms of today's time, Corona, COVID times, if you have the IP, intellectual property, say license to manufacture the vaccine, it is far, 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 far bigger than any building, than any ship or any kind of fixed assets, right? So this is what I'm trying to tell you. Similarly, a license of a product like Gmail or a license of a product like, Microsoft Windows, this is far bigger than a fixed asset, which if you go to any bank or if you go to any chartered accountant who's not into this, they will say your valuation is nil. Okay. And bank will give you loan, chartered accountant will say aapka kuch nahi ho sakta. And so you have to approach the right people. I'm not saying go to Startup Planes only. There are so many other players. You have to find out the right one who gives you the best pricing. Second is, once you ascertain that your valuation is good, then you have to find out how much amount you have to raise. Whether you are willing to dilute 10% equity, 15%, 16%, do not go more than 16 or 17% of equity initially. Then the third step comes to take the decision whether to find out the investors yourself or find out the investors through a platform. So it is as good as, opening your own shop versus Amazon, selling on Amazon. Selling on Amazon will give you immediate kickstart, but will give you, there is a cost attached to it in long run. So Amazon will charge every time you sell a product, and maybe your shop will be very handy in long run, will give you more returns. So you have to take that decision whether you want Startup Planes to raise funds for you. We have already created the entire infrastructure. We keep on having those demo days, but there is a cost attached. In case you wish to do it, you have to find out at least two people in the team. I'll tell you the process what to do. You will find investors in two sources. Either people who have good amount of money in their pocket, or who have already invested. That is how you can find the angel investors I'm talking about. So finding good people, people having good money, you can go to LinkedIn, and anybody running a good business, or maybe have invested in the past, made good money, or celebrities, anyone who has money, you can approach them. Second is, you go to yourstory.com. In fact, Startup Planes also cover such funding stories or anything. I said Your Story because yes, they are the leaders. You go to yourstory.com, find out which company got funded. They will also reveal the investors, or if they don't, sometimes in most of the cases they won't. Go to Ministry of Corporate Affairs, ask your chartered accountant to do it and download the public information. They will give you the shareholder structure and you will get to know who has invested in this company. And then you can approach those people. There are various tools available online through which you can extract their email ID, phone numbers. Right? But this is a complicated process. if you want, you can approach Startup Lanes. We can do this and we can give you a kickstart in maybe a week's time. Okay.
Okay, so just to answer your question, you said you should have a fixed assets. Yes, our business has a lot of fixed assets in requirement, which we already invested, and those are there in the place. Number two, one thing
I would like to tell you is, asset heavy businesses are not fundable by angel investors.
Okay.
So imagine if Uber starts buying the taxi, then this becomes non-fundable business because platforms are in, scalability really get hampered. Plus, there is a lot of work to be done in maintenance of those assets. So that is a old model of business.
I got your point. That's also depreciated value. I mean, every year this value of those fixed assets get reduced. My business is a recurring business. I mean, whatever the customer buys today, it's like internet connections or your set-top box or your, you know, we are into the data center cloud computing business. So it's a recurring business. Every year the customer, whatever service he's taking, he has to pay every month. And the termination or the churn is very, very low. That's the model of this.
That's a very good business. Subscription income is the best.
Yeah, so we started with a very small scale of 5-10 customers. As of now, I'm holding more than 100 customers, as of today, which we've been serving. We had a 6-people team. Now we are having a close to 22-people team, which have been working, and we are self-sufficient. And it's not like for the paying the salary, we need to raise the funds. No, that's not like that. Why need to expand this business for the other state of the country and the international business? So that's the only objective.
If you ask me, it is pretty fundable. This is the right time to raise funds.
All right. So I'll connect with your team on a one-to-one basis.
Right. So you go to Startup Lanes. There is a page of funding in the menu. You'll find out and read out that. It will take 10 to 15 minutes of time. We have explained what kind of funding you'll get, what is the process, how you can, how much amount you should raise initially and all that. It will take 10-15 minutes for you to read. After that, there is a link, apply there, it goes to the system and you will definitely get a call from our side.
Excellent. Thank you so much,
sir. Pleasure. All right. So Anjali, do we have any more questions? I see somebody saying in the chat, please answer my question. So. Who's that person? Can you take that?
Yes, Chandra Shekhar is asking. Hi, I'm looking for a debt funding for a clean tech funding. My startup has an order book in form of a LOI. How can you help?
Tech funding of how much? Is it mentioned?
No, sir.
So, that's a very generic question. You have to apply through Startup Lanes website and there's a large team willing and keen to help you. So we'll definitely be able to raise funds for you.
Deepak Jha wants to ask you a question. So Deepak Jha, you can ask, please.
Yeah, hi. Actually, I have a question that I'm running an on-demand cleaning and utility service company, just like Urban Clap or Urban Company for that matter. So what has happened, we have been running this company for the last four and a half years. So it was like in the last year, for the last 12 months or 6 months for that matter, we have been able to expand to different parts of India through by selling our franchisee. I mean, we are alone in this space who have managed to actually sell the entire SOPs and everything, the training modules and everything, and we have managed to appoint franchisee after taking a significant amount as a franchisee, as a brand fee. So now what happens, if I look into the space, we are very strong in B2B, and in B2B space, our profitability is on a very, very higher side as compared to B2C. But in B2B again, it's more of a sales driven and feet on street concept, rather than any particular use of AI for acquiring the customers. So if I want to foray into B2C now, because we are already there we are sitting on more than 250 franchisee queries across India. So in that particular case, is it the right time to approach the investors? I mean, how to take it ahead?
Yeah, that's pretty fine. If you talk about, I will not name those companies, but if you talk about the leaders in the segment, they are also not using artificial intelligence, right? There is no AI. So, okay. It's all about, see, if I have to get my hair cut by a barber coming at my home, I don't actually need an AI, I need a good barber. And if you're able to provide that and the customer comes back, you are far better. And if you are able to disrupt in terms of pricing, then automatically customer will shift to you, because majority of India, your customer is middle class, right? And that middle class is price sensitive. If your competitor is selling a haircut for say 150 rupees and you do it for 75, then you get the deal, right? And that is how it is going to scale up. Your AI or anything is not required. What is required is, if you are getting, like I said in the previous example, if you are getting 85% of your new business coming organically through references,
right,
then it is the right time. Or else, if you have a very established model of CACs to NTV and, you know, O2O model, leads coming digitally into the sales funnel, getting qualified and the conversion rate is very high, go for it. Immediately you get funding, immediately. Because again, a technology model which is a pure mathematics, provenly happening for last 3 to 6 months, it's you know, any investor can put in funds into that, any investor.
Thank you.
Okay, any more questions?
Yes sir, Sandeep Kumar is asking. Hi, I would like to know, how can I find the best co-founder? Also, I would like to know, is incubator a good approach to start the work of my project, because currently it's an idea stage and document stage. Please guide me, how should I start?
Okay, so the best way to find out a co-founder is start going to all the forums. A lot of communities are available. Startup Lanes itself has a lot of communities. You go to those communities. It is free to join entirely. And for message like finding a co-founder, we also don't ask you to become a paid member. But if you are really serious about it, what you can do is you can become a paid member. Generally, except Mumbai, most of the cities, we have membership of 10,000 rupees for 1 year. And then you can utilize our, network to find out the co-founder. What we'll do is we'll share it on all the communities. And this is not the only benefit you are going to get. There are several other benefits that are exclusively for our gold members. You can become that and you can find out your co-founder. Now, if you talk about incubator, Startup Lanes is also an incubator. There are two types of incubators. One is online, other is offline. Offline, in Corona times, nobody is working. So all you have got choice is online incubator. In online incubator, we are a cloud incubator. That means in online also there are different models. So we are a cloud incubator. That means a lot of people will be, your co-founders will be working from different places. But thankfully, the best part with a cloud incubator like us is, because we created this model, you don't have to look for co-founders. We'll give you co-founders as well. Plus, we will, if your idea is good, we'll take that idea, or else we'll give you an idea as well. And the entire team start working on one particular idea. If you want to explore that option, you can contact Anjali. We are about to incubate a startup called Gantri, which is, a connection of aggregation of local car mechanics and making them, a branded one by establishing their SOPs and creating a brand out of it. Okay, and I can take questions for 9 more minutes. I have a hard stop at, in 9 more minutes. So it's like 5:30.
Prabhakar, you can ask the question. Prabhakar Pali.
Yeah, hi Shishir. Myself Prabhakar and I'm from Hyderabad. We have a mobile application which is not yet been launched yet. Which is in developing mode. Currently, it would be taking another 2 weeks of time to launch in. And basically, this is for the B2C market, just like Urban Clap. I just want to take your inputs on the, because we are new to this segment, I don't know about how the copyrights and, patents would be followed with this kind of applications work in Indian market. And also, we want to go for international market like the Middle East kind of segment. Because it's a global application, it's a B2C market, anyone can use this kind of segment. I want to seek your advice for someone who want to get into this kind of market, and I don't know about the age limit or anything as such, because currently myself and my friend both of us are working on this market, because he's based out of Middle East and I'm working in Indian market. We both are in the initial stage, so I want to take your guidance at this stage.
So if I am understanding correct, you are asking me about the patents in the Indian markets.
Both for Indian and also for the international market.
Okay. So, for international, first, you know, there is a matric pact for the patents. Yeah, that means you need to, for 1 year, if you go about this arrangement, for 1 year, your patent will be treated as an international global patent. After that, you have to register your patent in each of the markets you will be operating, or you have the risk of competing. Generally, what companies do it, they register, Indian companies I'm talking about, even the US companies, they register their patent specially in India and then China. Very important, because you understand for obvious reasons. Then they register in their patent in US and they float a C corporation, C Corp in Delaware. And this C Corp owns the US patent as well as the Indian as well as the Chinese patent. They don't create a mother and a sister kind of structure, neither mother nor sister concerned. There will be independent companies. Then you can merge those companies in the company that is performing well, or you can transfer the IPs. So this will give you a flexibility. That means what I am trying to tell you is, opening up a company, depending upon what kind of structure you have and what kind of budget you have. If you have very good budget, you know, float one company in India, float one company in Singapore and one in the US, and your Singapore company will become the vehicle for raising funds from the Asian markets. In case you are getting funding from US, you can take the funding in that particular organization and merge the Singapore and Indian entity into that one, right? And the last one, if that is possible, you can float the company in India, raise funds in India, scale up as an Indian company, and then merge your US entity and Singapore entity into it. And you might not even require Singapore entity if you raise funds in India, right? So that is how it goes. But another aspect is, if for building your credibility with the international clients, it is always advisable to float at least one company in US or maybe Singapore, because of the laws and the disputes. Singapore entity is very, very suitable and very much preferred in terms of handling the disputes, because international disputes could be handled very well if your company is floated there in Singapore.
Sushil, if I would like to reach offline, apart from this, to take some more guidance, can you help me out? How should I be able to reach you?
Yeah, one-to-one advisory is like, either if you are an international customer, you have to go through clarity.fm. There the pricing is around, there's a...
I'm domestic. I'm from India.
Domestic, 1500 rupees for 20 minutes. You can go to Startup Lane's website and there's an option to talk to the CEO, book a call. It will show you the available slots. You can pick up a slot, and for domestic, we have created a facility. You just have to pay one time, and then you can get some WhatsApp support and all. That means, any consultancy you require over the WhatsApp, it is a minor issue or something, small required, we don't ask you to book a call again.
Sure, Shishir. I'll take it further from this. And thank you so much for the initiative, and I'm following you for a long time. And I'm going to...
So nice of you. Honor for me. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
All right. So one last question, and that will be all, and then we'll meet again next Tuesday. Anjali.
Yes. Yeah. You can ask the question.
Sorry. I have a question actually. We are a self-funded company, and we have been in operation since 5+ years. We are into home automation system. We are manufacturer. Now the problem is, we are trying to scale, especially establishing the dealers and installation network. and there we are failing there because people are not keen to take us to the customer because they are dealing in like 4 or 5 different brands, and whichever brand suits to the end customer, they just push that. So in this case, should we go for like funding so they can connect us to better or relevant dealers or other installer, or rather I should focus on expanding myself the dealer network? And by the way, we have zero experience in marketing and sales. We are all just technical people.
Okay. What I'll suggest you is to build a model similar to Oaktel. Oaktel's founder is same, Shishir Gupta. I'm not that guy. He's from IIT and he is into a similar product line. They sell through Amazon, they sell directly to the consumer. A lot of options are available. Now, imagine, you know, if you have to automize your process of switching on and off the AC from remote and your AC does not support it. If there is a device for say 1500, 2000 rupees which can facilitate this, then a consumer can buy this and plug it in and then put the main switch on this particular AC's plug into it. And this works. So it's a better option, no? So these kind of innovative products you have to think. Instead of B2B, you have to focus more on B2C, because B2B, your product goes to people who will squeeze you up, like builders, interior designers and decorators, right? They might squeeze you. So you have to focus upon direct to consumers. You may tie up with companies like you know, there are interior companies, I do not remember that startup name. I think House App or something like that, I do not remember. They have a very large segment. Even you can tie up with companies like Pepperfry. So, lot of scope is there to tie up and go ahead. But going for B2C segments like builders and interior designers would be a difficult task. As far as funding you are talking about, if you build that model, good. And one more thing, you said you are not good in sales. So at Startup Lanes, we have a model. We have three things. We are focusing on funding, branding and sales. So we also generate leads for our members. Two ways to generate those leads. One way is through the community. We put you into a community with different segment people, and they have the responsibility of bringing in business reference for each one, at least for one member. So this way, you know, every week people get references and business generation. Second is we build in external leads through our sales funnel, and those leads are passed to our members. And there is a markup fee that is paid to SL for, you know, running the contracts, managing the entire thing, for managing the escrows. Lot of things are there. There are, you know, 15, 16 services that we include into that for a small markup fee. So we can give you that kind of business. Plus we have our own communities. We have a very happening community of 7,700 curated startups. So those can also become your customers.
Okay, great. I'll think that.
So you can check out the gold membership option at Startup Lanes website. If you go, you'll find out membership in the menu and read out that, and then you can leave your fill up a very small form and you will get a call from our side, and then they will explain you other benefits as well.
Okay, thank you very much.
All right, so thank you so much. The time is up. I would have loved to discuss on and on because this is what I do and I love doing this, but unfortunately time does not allow. I have to hop in for other calls, and this was a very enjoyable session for me. Thank you everyone. And please meet again next Tuesday. I'm not sure about the fixed time of 4 o'clock, but definitely we'll inform you. There will be a meetup, same question and answer session next Tuesday as well. All right.
Thank you. Thank you, Shishir.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Shishir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.